Hey Modest Pelican, your holiday's over. It's time to make a new video.
Oh yeah, true.
Hey mate, what's going on?
Hey Stealtho Carbo, did you want to play some Red Dead Online with me?
Unsolicited nude photos to my family, then, sure.
Deal.
Hi lads and lasses, Modest Pelican here, and unlike 32% of your fathers, I actually came back. If you enjoyed this video, please go to a graveyard and engrave on every tombstone, subscribe to Modest Pelican or I will haunt you, so the grieving relatives subscribe, as this really helps spread the good word of my channel. Also, please like the video, it's what Queen Marto II would want. I asked Marto if I could keep using his face to help boost engagement on my videos, and he said maybe, which is all the consent I needed. Anyway, I spawn into the game, and for some reason I'm out in the wilderness, but at least it makes the perfect setting for our first family-friendly bit. I'll be joined today by Stealtho Carbo. They say slapstick comedy is by far the most intelligent type of humour, and so it feels good knowing all the little baddies will think we're smart. I receive an alert saying bounty hunters are trying to kill me, which is confronting, so I decide I will attempt to evade them. As I canter along the road, aggressively tapping my A button because that's a fun and definitely not outdated gameplay mechanic, I'm viciously killed by AL2507. The dodgy Malacca was a bounty hunter and clearly had no respect for me. Today this changes. Today we become the Alpha Cowboy. Why does that sound like I'm about to have sex with a man? Anyway, I ride up on AL2507 and gun the big girl down. It's a strange phenomenon watching someone carry your own body to sell to their town's sheriff, kind of hot. We ride off into the night on our new mission to earn the other player's respect.
The lights in this are unreal. It's almost like accurate lighting.
It's almost as good as GTA expanded and enhanced. Yeah, come on, Will, back to school shopping.
We proceed to buy an excessive amount of guns and ammunition. We then clean the outside of our weapons with a cloth because that makes them shoot better, and then I spot something on the map. A photo studio. We figure it would be rude not to get a few sneaky photos together.
This is a seedy alley, man. Like, this looks like we're gonna shoot a porno or something. Oh, okay, no.
We're not?
Well, classy one, look at this.
I'm inside you, apparently.
You are inside me. You should say this, Spider-Man. It's really special.
The next thing that will help us get respect from other players is fresh new drip. For this, we need money, so it's time to do some unique and fun missions that will either be capturing someone or hijacking a wagon. Speaking of sarcasm, the GTA Enhanced and Expanded trailer was absolutely amazing. For those of you that don't know, they're re-releasing GTA 5 for the 15th time, but on new consoles and now with yellow number plates. I grew up playing GTA 5, and I'm excited because my unborn children will now also grow up playing GTA 5. I wonder what a Red Dead Online Expanded and Enhanced trailer would look like. Probably something like this. Welcome to Red Dead Online Expanded and Enhanced, where we've implemented all the one change you've been waiting for. After much anticipation, the balls of horses will now shrink even smaller than ever before when you visit cold areas of the map. With horse nuts more dynamic than ever, you can enjoy true immersion for $89.99. We arrive at James Langton's campsite to see what he can offer us. The big man takes a draw of his cigarette before engaging in conversation, so you know he's an alpha cowboy. James asks if we can rescue some prisoners, and we're happy to be of assistance. One of my close friends actually went to prison, and I used to visit him, and I was the least scary of all the visitors. This is a true story, I'm not bantering. Everyone else who visited looked like they were in a gang, and then there was just me, an epic gamer. When we visited, we were allowed to take in a piece of paper and a pen. The inmates weren't allowed to take the paper back to the cell without a guard checking first, and I thought it would be funny to draw an escape plan on the piece of paper. I drew little stick figures jumping over a wall, but yeah, apparently the guards take that sort of thing very seriously. It was quite the comedic misfire. We drop these two back to safety and then spot a picturesque desert lake. You know what that means? It's time for an ambitious Modest Pelican fishing segment. Smack my ass
like the drum. Yo, this is a beautiful lake. What the hell?
You know what, Jeff? I think it's almost a fishing lake.
At what point am I just a fishing channel, dude?
Rex Hunt.
It's like for a moment you forget that we've been in lockdown for a year and you don't have depression.
I wish I only had depression.
Go on.
Nice cock.
Wow, what a pretty good segment. I swim across the lake with my horse, and guess who's living in the house right by the water? James Langton, the big man himself. Still taking a drag of his cigarette right before he speaks. They just don't breed them like this anymore. Kids these days never smoke. They're a bunch of weak dogs. We've signed up to do the final part of the railroad contract, which is going to have to be pretty damn fun, as it has to follow that innovative and exciting fishing segment. Carbo chooses to jump across to my horse and tenderly hold my waist. If you aren't cuddling your bros, you're not really bros. You're just close friends, which isn't very alpha cowboy. I'm getting quite into doing missions stealthily. It's quite hard, but you can do it with the bow and arrow. There's something so satisfying about taking down enemies with an arrow.
Okay, I think he's dead, bro. That's some pent up anger you've got.
No. You've misunderstood me. Kidneys failed the other week. I'm getting his other one.
We destroy the wagons as instructed, and then move on to their main base to destroy the rest of the supplies. This reminds me of the time this girl and I went into the forest together on a date. It was honestly pretty romantic, until she started saying she wanted to be the president one day. I was like, yo, we live in Australia, we have a prime minister, not a president. But she was like, nah man, I'm going to be the president of the United States of America. I just found her dream so improbable that I stopped talking to her. Years later, one afternoon after my Mediterranean cooking class, I turn on my iPad mini and guess who I see? There she is being inaugurated as the US president. Her name was Barack Obama. I think this says a lot about society's social constructs.
Oh my god, look at the night sky.
It's crazy to think that somewhere up there on a space station, someone's watching gay porn.
We continue forward on our mission to earn respect from other players. Definitely one of my looser concepts for a video, but we're going with it. We arrive at a fence and buy superior weaponry such as dynamite, Molotov cocktails, and plenty of Capitale. And Capitale is this premium currency you need to play the fun missions. I used real life money to get some, but you can earn it in game without paying. So long as you don't have a job, friends, a kosher with slave labor, and don't mind doing the exact same mission over and over again. We find another blood money contact, and he is quite surprised to see us. He actually points a gun at me, but I proceed to do the brave thing and shake my head like a schoolgirl. He says he'll give us missions if we can help him with something. He wants us to rob a stagecoach, which is actually quite exciting as I've only ever done this 15,000 times before. I think it's time Rockstar give the fans the update to Red Dead Online we all deserve. The ability to date and eventually marry your bros in the Alpha Cowboy expansion pack. I mean Undead Nightmare 2. We complete his mission, and now we should be sweet to do a high-paying heist. It's at this moment I realize I've been wearing the same outfit for like 10 videos, and it's time to get a new look. We make our way down to I Don't See Color Water to buy some drip. I also realize that I can swing my machete off my horse to turn this game into some sort of medieval knight experience, which is cool. I hitch my horse up outside the outfitter because immersion, and then buy the perfect jacket. This will allow me to be taken far more seriously in the Wild West. Carbo proceeds to pay me a high tier compliment.
What do you think? Am I sensei now?
You look like you're about to teach me the way of the sword.
Moments later, we are fired upon by another crew, which is hard to believe, as look at my character. I chase the big girl into one of the pubs, and then something truly shocking happens. I walk into a bedroom, and this dodgy Malacca is corner camping in Red Dead Redemption. That's like drop-shotting in Minecraft or having virtual sex in Roblox. Well, actually, there's apparently a lot of virtual sex being had on Roblox. It's a real issue they struggle with. I'm not kidding. Someone needs to do an investigative report into the Roblox sex industry. It's far worse than the normal sex industry because the only limitation is your imagination. A few other cultured players join Carbo and I, and we eradicate the corner camping scum. They don't concede defeat, though, as they attempt to chase us out of Blackwater, but their resistance is futile. It's now actually time to complete a heist. The Ember of the East, which sounds like some good, clean, family-friendly fun. Stealtho, Robbo, and Jezzo also join the crew, which really warms my heart.
Oh, we got all the boys here. Robbie, do you want to say some words?
Okay, boys. Going in for these jewels or something. And the boss needs us to get in and get her done. So we're going to get in. Jeff, love the new fit.
Thank you. Thank you, man. Actually means
on
a lot.
On a side note.
What word comes to mind when you see this outfit?
Oriental.
The boys together at last as we ride into Annisburg to search for some chest. I head straight to the mineshaft and start taking down what I can only assume are underpaid immigrants. Seriously, who else would work this job? It's 3 a.m. and they're willingly standing in a mine to guard a mystery chest. Although they are just NPCs, I'm probably looking too far into it. I do, however, have a theory that NPCs aren't controlled by artificial intelligence, but rather Venezuelan children. Things the 1% don't want you to know. Stealtho Robbo finds the chest, and I didn't even get to watch him open it. $5 well spent. On the bright side, we got to take a train all the way home, so all you viewers who are only here for the train cinematography will be happy. We were all on miniguns, ready to take down anyone who tried to stop us, which was literally one horse, and it died violently. Kind of anticlimactic, and there's now only one thing that can save the ending of this video. Another fishing segment.
That's all fish next to each other.
Whoa.
Behemoth of a fish. I can just pick it up and grab it. Got one, boys. You got a whole crowd. Everyone's watching you. Everyone's watching you, Will.
Heaps of line.
I'm doing it.
I was joking about becoming a fishing channel, but this is actually turning into a fishing channel. Maybe in GTA Expanded and Enhanced, they just need to add fishing.
Hey, quick, pump that. Another down and up, down and up. Yeah, Will.
You can do it. Hey! Oh, he's done it! Now that's a catch.
Yeah. Thanks for watching, you absolute legends. Until next time, and as always, stay classy.